All right, I just took a shot at the muskrat. I know I hit him, but question is, where did he go? Lori's gonna try to go over there and see if she can find him with the net, because we want to eat him, because they're delicious. All right, we're on the back deck here, and there is a reason that our first shooting target over there is of a muskrat. Oh, I see him. He's right there. He's right there in front of the cement pad. Well, he was just up to the top. Well, he'll come back up. There we go. We got us a muskrat. Oh, he's a fat little guy, isn't he?
I'm just wondering. I'm just hoping it's not a mama.
Where's he hit at?
I don't know. I don't know if he is hit or if he just stunned it.
Yeah, I don't think we just stunned it.
I think you just stunned it.
All right, not sure. Roll him over again. We can't really tell where we hit him at.
I wonder if you just stunned him.
Lori thinks we just stunned him. But that don't make no sense.
Lock-a-bye, baby.
Yeah, he's not looking too healthy.
He's not. He's going fast.
Yeah, I think we hit him, and then being in the water, it's probably just washed all the blood off of him, and it's hard to tell where he's hit at.
He's giving up.
Yeah, he's about gone. One of the reasons that we're harvesting this muskrat is he has built a den up underneath our walking path. And eventually that will end up collapsing and we'll have to repair it, but we don't want to have to worry about somebody walking on that path and it caving in and twisting or breaking an ankle or a leg or something. So the muskrats have got to find another place to live, and this one's going to live in my belly. All right, it's time to clean our muskrat here. He built a den up underneath our walking path, which will make it eventually collapse. So we decided we needed to get the muskrats out of there. And this guy is going to be delicious. I've eaten muskrat before. Probably the best meat I've ever had in my life. So we're going to go ahead and get him cleaned and put him in the pot, so to speak. Well, actually, Lori will soak him in some milk. Soak the meat in some milk overnight, and then we'll take and fry them up. So first thing we gotta do is get rid of the head, and we have not shot him in the head. He was shot somewhere, we cannot tell where, because he's not bleeding, because he was in the water when we shot him, and but he's hit somewhere because he died. So anyway, here we go. We're going to try to save as much of this skin as possible, because the skin on these things is just wonderful. See the teeth they got on them? Would not want to get bit by one of those guys when they're alive. So you can see how dark this meat is. When you cook this up, it's kind of almost tastes like chicken gizzards, but without the gristly part. It's really dark, rich, thick meat. Oh, looks like we see where we shot him. Right here in the side, you can see the congealed blood hematoma there. And I see an entry wound, but I do not see an exit wound. Just the one right there. Oh. There's the exit wound, and look at that, the bullet just fell right out. Got stuck there between here and the skin. Did not quite make it back out. That's kind of interesting, haven't had that happen before. And I'm sure there's a more professional way of skinning a muskrat, but I do things I'm not an expert at all the time. And so we're just going to kind of muscle this off of him as best we can. Cut around. The fur pulled off the front paws pretty easily, but the back feet are kind of big. I'm afraid I'm going to tear this if I try to pull that too far. We're going to cut it. And that'll let that skin come right off the feet. Same thing on this side. Alright, so I pretty much got all the skin off there. I'm going to cut the tail. And then we'll let Lori play with cleaning this up. Getting all the extra meat and skin and or meat and fat and stuff like that off of here. We'll have a nice muskrat pelt there. All right. And the rest of this, just cleaning this guy up and putting him in the, getting him ready for the frying pan. These guys here, they're called muskrats for a reason. And we're going to take anything that looks like it's not meat, anything that looks like fat or gland, we're going to make sure we pull that off of there so we don't bite into anything that might make us go, oh, well, that's why they call it a muskrat, because it's musky flavored or something. We don't want that. So we'll get all this stuff, all these little, like I said, anything that's yellow or white, we're going to pick off of this thing and make sure we don't put it in the frying pan. See, that looks like some sort of gland there. Could just be fat. I don't know. I'm not an expert, but again, I'm not eating anything that's white or yellow on this thing. All right, we got a bunch of muskrat guts. It looks like, yeah, those are, must be the testicles. And a lot of this sort of stuff, we don't necessarily eat it, but we use it for fish bait. Works pretty good. Everything except for all this this gut that's just gonna have vegetative matter or whatever in it. The stomach here, all that sort of stuff we throw away, but this liver, I guess you could eat it if you wanted to, but again, we got enough catfish poles around here to where we usually find a good use for it on that. So that muskrat liver will go on a fishing pole and we'll catch us a catfish with it. Not sure what that is. I don't think it's liver. I don't know if that's some sort of kidney or not. There's the other one over here. So I'm guessing that's a kidney. Not really round or bean-shaped like a lot of kidneys are, but I'm guessing that's what that is. Alright, up in here, we got the heart and the lungs. Again, I guess you could eat those if you wanted to, but it'll go on a catfish pole. And we're going to cut through this pelvic part here, and then we'll get rid of any other of these parts that we don't want. We should just, for the most part, just pull off. I'm guessing that is the penis. I'm glad I got gloves on. Alright, again, see that little white thing there? That's probably some sort of gland or something. I'm not eating it. Same thing with all this stuff up underneath the legs. I'm not well versed on muskrat anatomy and what all these little pieces parts are. Again, I know anything white or yellow. Not something I want to eat. And I know a lot of these glands are up in the joints of the limbs. And make sure we pull some of those muscles apart, spread them out a little bit so that we can make sure that if there is a little gland or something up in there, we find it and can get rid of it. This looks like this is just a bunch of ligaments here, but I don't need to eat those either. Since I got a hold of them, I'll just cut them off. Well, easier said than done, apparently. There we go. Alright, got this guy clean enough. I'm going to take him into the kitchen sink and finish working on him there underneath some running water. Again, we can see where we had our exit wound over here. Our entry wound was right there. Went through here and came out over here, right there, in and out. So if you get the opportunity to get you a muskrat, like I said, this is probably the best meat I've ever eaten in my life. It's just so rich, so red, so dark, and it comes out and it's just, like I said, I'm 53 years old and never eaten anything better than this. Alright, last thing before we take them inside, we're just going to cut the feet off because I don't plan on frying them up. Just do that with a pair of dykes, wire cutters. All right, so we got our muskrat meat cut up, and it's in the fridge. And Lori's gonna try to clean the skin here. We have heard that you can take a power washer, which is sitting right there, and spray all the meat and fat and goop, blood, off these skins. So she's gonna nail this out, and then we're gonna take the power washer to it and see if it really works.
Up my skin.
Alright, so Lori's got that nailed down. She's going to go turn on the hose, and we're going to see if we can do this without destroying the skin.
not exactly a dry process. You'll get me a towel. So that seemed to work pretty good. A little bit of fat and stuff to pull off here on the edges, but overall it's pretty clean. So we will use that method again for sure. It's not exactly a dry method though. Get a lot of stuff sprayed back at you, which I don't know about the taste of. Muskrat guts in your mouth, so you might want to keep your mouth closed. And wear some glasses. I think next time I'll wear a full face plastic shield. might work a little better. So, good deal. Now what are you going to do with this?
I've got to sit it up over here and get some salt on it. Let it sit for a little while. Make sure I bring it in so the raccoons don't get it tonight.
Yeah. Critters to eat it. Alright.
There he is.
There we go. One muskrat pelt.
in the making.